Going beyond our reasonable service. How far do we have to go before we go beyond our reasonable service? We must put every bit of effort that can possibly be put into the ministry to be able to accomplish everything that we must accomplish. So I was thinking about just how far we would have to go before we went beyond our reasonable service. I thought about Moses and the wonderful leader that he was and the many things that were accomplished through his leadership. On one occasion, Moses was called up to the mountain and God gave him the Ten Commandments. But the children of Israel had called Aaron and the other officials together and demanded a God. They completely denied a living God who had delivered them out of the land of Egypt. Now when God looked down on them and saw what they had done, he decided to put an end to them. God called Moses and he said, "I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. Now therefore, let me alone, that my wrath may wax hot against them, and that I may consume them. I will make of thee a great nation." Here was a chance for Moses to make a name for himself and be an outstanding man. But Moses had love for those people. It would have been easy for him to let God destroy them and make something big out of him. But Moses' vision went beyond that. He began to plead with God, and he talked to the people. Moses went back to the mountain and got in touch with God again. You see, the Bible said that he spoke to him face to face. He really got close to God. He talked to him just like talking to a friend. If we get a little bit of Moses' love in operation, we'll be able to really reprove the members more than once. But now think about God's mercy being so far beyond man that we cannot even comprehend the mercy that God has. But it seems as if this man, Moses, at this moment probably had more mercy than God. But it would have been easy for Moses to say that he had done all he could. But he said, "I'll talk to God again." You see, sometimes it is that last prayer that counts. Moses said, "If thou wilt forgive their sin, and if not, blot me, I pray thee, out of thy book." If you can't forgive them, in other words, he was saying, just let them perish. If we had more of that love operating in the church of God today, I'm so sure to say that we would see a great reunification of God's children. His love was extended so far beyond God's love that God stood up and took notice of him. He went beyond his reasonable service. The Lord said to Moses, "I will do this thing also that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight." Not because the people found grace, but because Moses found grace in his sight. God bless you.